Can you keep a secret, Gaia? Renegade Radio this morning reached contract agreement with the radio station to bring our show to the morning. We're on the air, my friend. Starting Monday, we go to work. You, me, and Buff are the only ones who have any say in what goes on the air.
7:51 p.m.
KF, Jimmy Buff.
It's time to move. We got action, or roll cameras, whatever. And I want to fill you in on the details, okay? And if not, you can call Uncle Curdy, all right? We'll talk. Bye-bye.
KF, I'll talk to you later. It's 7 o'clock now. But when you talk to these record companies, you got to sound real enthusiastic. We're about to go on the air. These are a couple of renegades right out of WNEW-FM. Backed up Dave Herman for the last 6 years on the morning show with a creative driving force behind the Dave Herman show. Now they're stepping out front, and they know the market, and they have a fantastic format, an exciting new show. Reminiscent of the old NEW, playing all the best new music. There's nothing like it anywhere in New York, and it's going to put all the excitement back in radio in the mornings. We're putting our library together. We're focusing on new music, but we need a library, too, because we're going to be dabbling in some of the classics.
Det är just därför radioprogrammet UN transmitterat när förmest radiostationet WNWK, 95.5 FM.
Okay, troops, we'll be landing at our target radio station in 30 seconds. Our enemies are the corporately programmed radio stations that want to maintain the status quo on the airwaves. They want to keep things predictable and safe. And they'll stop at nothing to try to shut us down. Your mission is to provide the ground support and secure the area so we can liberate listeners from the grip of corporately programmed radio. Because that's not rock and roll. This is rock and roll for the 90s. This is Radio Free New York. 0 hour. Let's go!
I blow it up!
Take cover!
Give me that. This is Radio Free New York. 105.9 WNWK is now Radio Free New York.
Good morning, it's 6:23. I'm Kurt Chaplin with Jimmy Buff. This is Radio Free New York. We are on the air for you finally after 8 long, hard months of fighting and fighting and fighting for a chance to bring you the best music ever played on the radio in New York City in the mornings. We made it. Wasn't easy, Buffy.
No, it wasn't easy.
Wasn't easy.
Nothing good ever is.
Well, it's going to get easier from here. Today is a beautiful day, 47 degrees, sunny and breezy, maybe all the way up into the 70s. A beautiful weekend coming up. And we started out with The Stand from The Alarm, and we wondered for weeks, what's the first song we're going to play? Turns out,
we decided about 30 seconds.
A last-minute decision.
Before
The Stand from The Alarm, from originally off Declaration. Now, we played it off Standards, which is their best of album, issued in 1990 on IRS. Followed it with Michael Penn's Strange Season. Well, for Free For All, that's a brand new release from BMG. I don't think the album's even out yet, as far as we know. And why stop now? This is Material Issue. Hey, you got to get up anyway. Great way to start off Radio Free New York. Can't do better than a couple of soundtrack cuts back to back. That was B.B. King from Thelma and Louise, the movie Better Not Look Down. And before that, Material Issue, we dug that out of Hellraiser 3, an insane horror movie with a wild soundtrack. But we found that's what girls want. We thought it was good enough to play on the radio for you. And that's what Radio Free New York is all about. And before that, Michael Penn's Strange Season off Free For All, and the first song we ever played on Radio Free New York. It'll go down in history. It's the answer to the trivia question. The Stand.
Get the Museum of Broadcasting on the phone now.
Well, this is a sneak preview of Radio Free New York, and this is the show that everyone's been talking about. This is the show that the buzz in the streets is all about. This is Radio Free New York. This is what you may have read about in the Daily News on Wednesday morning in Richard Johnson's column. This is a show Buffy and I have been working on since we left WNEW-FM back in February. And why did we leave WNEW-FM? Well, there were a number of reasons. Number one, they booted us out.
They said, you're fired.
Yeah.
That's a good reason.
You know, and we had to leave. But the reason they said that we were fired was because, you know, we said there has to be a better way to do radio. And we kept going to management and saying things like, you know, we want to play certain songs and we want some freedom. We want to do real good radio in the morning. And management's message to Buff and myself was, look, we're making money here for the corporation, Group W, Westinghouse Broadcasting. We know we're not serving the audience very well, but we're making money. So you two guys, stop rocking the boat or get off. Well, we got off. We built our own boat, and it's called Radio Free New York. Here we are, so call your friends, tell them to tune in. I know the article said we'd be on starting October 12th, but this is a special sneak preview of Radio Free New York. You know, for the last couple of months, once we got started working on this show and we knew we were going to be on, I can't even get through to Buff anymore. I can't even call your house anymore. I'm always told you're doing the same thing. You're listening to music. You're listening to music. And you dug something out here.
I dug out the Oyster Band. They're an Irish band. They're signed to Ryko Disc. They're not a major label, but they're terrific.
Let's see what they sound like on Radio Free New York, the Oyster Band.
The deserter says, 608 Radio Free New York. It's Monday, and we made it back on the air with Grant Lee Buffalo starting us off this morning. The title track from Fuzzy and the right there, Dogs of Lust from the Dusk CD. Hey, we're here, 47 degrees, partly sunny, chance of afternoon showers, high near 60. A little the worse for wear, but we are here. Radio Free New York at 105.9 WNWK. Lots of good new music to play for you today. Live stuff to play back for you today. Announcements to make about live artists coming up this week. We have an unbelievable concert on Thursday that we're going to announce for you in a little while. But first, this. These are the Judy Bats. Pain Makes You Beautiful is the name of the album. And from it all day afternoon at Radio Free New York, 105.9 WNWK. Six 17 Radio Free New York, and that's Soul Asylum from Grave Dancers Union, Runaway Train. Judy Batts before that, All Day Afternoon, off of their CD, Pain Makes You Beautiful.
You think that's true?
Well, you look
Come here, Truss.
Good.
Come here, a second.
Oh! You're very cute all of a sudden, Truss.
Thank you.
47 degrees, sunny, high with a sunny and high with a chance of rain. Oh, new music from 11th Dream Day coming right up. But first, Albie Truss in sports. Looking very good. Brought to you by Samuel Adams Boston Lager. Voted the best beer in America 4 years in a row at the Great American Beer Festival. They're still importing this beer into Germany. It's the only American beer they're doing that with.
Knicks Celtics yesterday. NBA action. The Knicks beating the Celtics by 12, 102-90. Patrick Ewing, the story here, 34 points. Rolando Blackman, 18 points. Very nice job. But however, the Mets played, and of course, the Mets got swept by the Astros. 5-4.
Of course.
Three-game sweep for the Astros.
Pothead posers.
I guess there's that Bobby Bonilla incident there.
What is it? Right field? Is there a problem in right field? It's the grass, right? Makes idiots of right fielders for the Mets.
We got a new Darryl Strawberry out there.
Today, it's the Yankees home opener at the stadium. It's Jim Abbott versus David Cohn against the Royals at 1 o'clock, and that's Radio Free New York Sports.
You like golf?
No.
Good. You know, Bernard Langer won the Masters.
Yes, I did.
Just for your information.
Okay.
And for the latest in fashion for young people at the lowest prices, don't shop anywhere else but Young World. For the lowest prices and best service on young people's fashions and furniture.
621 Radio Free New York. This band is called 11th Dream Day. They have a CD out on Atlantic Records. They call it El Mudio. At 105.9 WNWK, this is a track called Motherland.
It's 6:30 at Radio Free New York at 105.9. Don't forget that 9. It's so important. If you forget the 9, that's it. But you didn't. Good. At WNWK, we're Radio Free New York. Not the same 20 songs over and over and over. The Beloved. 638 Radio Free New York, and that's Buffalo Tom with Staples from their album Let Me Come Over. The Beloved before that, their CD is Conscience, the track Sweet Harmony. Big Audio Dynamite, Rush from the Globe, and 11th Dream Day, brand new. A track called Motherland off of El Mudio, which is now available on Atlantic Records. And as promised when he went to break down on the other end of the dial, tell your friends that when he goes to break, the talk show, the negative talk show host down on the left, when he goes to break, come over to 105.9 and we'll play music. We'll be playing music, and that's what we did right there. 640 at Radio Free New York, we've got our review of our unsigned show. We had our unsigned showcase concert on Friday night. We'll have a review of that for you in just a few minutes, but right now something brand new from Johnny Clegg and Savuka.
Yes, in Baola. Yes, in Baola. Hum. Yes, in Baola. Yes, in Baola. Hum.
Seven o'clock at Radio Free New York. We're at 105.9. Don't forget the 9, WNWK. Licensed to Multicultural Broadcasting Incorporated out of Newark, New Jersey. But we're downtown in the village. You know that place where Chinatown, Little Italy, and Soho meet? It's like the Bermuda Triangle down here. We're Radio Free New York, and this is the new Kinks record. At Radio Free New York, and those are the Lost Boys, and they will be on stage tonight when Radio Free New York hits the stage with our unsigned concert series show number two, Lost Boys, Edge Park, and The Sense. What a show it's going to be tonight at Tilt.
That is going to be a great show.
We're going to be jamming the place, right, Charles?
That is correct.
It might just be you, me, and Buff and the bands there. I don't know.
I don't think so.
I hope not. You know, you never know until you get there, but it's tonight. The music starts at 9. We'll go... Wait, we'll finish off Good Friday, go right into Saturday. So join us at 179 Varick Street tonight, Radio Free New York's unsigned show. Oh, let me tell you, in just a couple of moments, we'll get to some new posies for you. But the Mets, why do the Mets do this? Not only did Vince Coleman whack Doc Gooden with a golf club in the clubhouse, an accident. But then Jay Horowitz, you know they were a PR director, Jay Horowitz?
Flack?
I worked with him for a while. The most uncooperative guy in sports, Jay Horowitz. Doesn't tell the truth and say, oh, he was swinging a golf club and accidentally hit Gooden and he's got a bruise.
What'd he say?
He says Gooden got bumped. Got bumped in the clubhouse. That's why he's not starting against the Dodgers last night. Remember last year when Bonilla called the clubhouse and tried to get an error changed by the official score and had a big blowout with the and Horowitz said, no, he was just, you know, calling home or something. Tried to cover that one up. Why do the Mets do that?
Boy, he's a professional liar.
Yeah, well, I guess that's why he does it then.
Wow.
At 6:38 at Radio Free New York, the new posies are on the other side of the Judy Bats. But here are the Bats themselves all day afternoon. Their album is Pain Makes You Beautiful, and if that's true, no wonder we all look so nice this morning. At Radio Free New York, 105.9 WNWK, new rock is not just for kids. And the Tragically Hips at the 100th Meridian from the Fully Completely CD. The Hips coming to town sometime soon. Somebody at our unsigned show on Saturday night was whispering to us, they're coming to town, coming to town. And we said, when? He said, I don't know. Big Head Todd and the Monsters before that. Sister Sweetly, the is the new CD on Giant Records, Bittersweet, the track, here at Radio Free New York, 105.9 WNWK. What kind of day is this going to be? They say rain heavy at times, but so far so good. It's really nice out right now. And if you have softball games at noon, you might be able to get them in. And meanwhile, here, we're in the studio, you know, taking on New York radio, right? We're taking on, like, the market. And we're paying our own money. We left NEW to do this show. We're taking on Howard Stern and trying to improve the conditions of radio in the morning. They're threatening to throw us off the air because there's a coffee cup in the back where Peter Himmelman played on Friday. So we're going to get thrown off the air for that. That's it, everybody. Sorry. We survived everything else, but we cannot survive that coffee cup. It's absurd.
The Aquarian Weekly is the complete rock and roll newspaper for people who believe in music.
Liberation from boring, corporately programmed radio. We're Radio Free New York in the mornings. At 7:32, the music is as hot as the day as we're in the middle of an Alternative Nation tribute set. And it continues with the Spin Doctors! Song. Go ahead, tell me. You can't, see? Frank Black and Places Named After Numbers from the Frank Black CD. Paul Weller before that from his also hippopotamously named album, Paul Weller and Bull Rush and Michael McDermott. And you know what? Just West of Eden comes off the album not named Michael McDermott. It's the only album in the set not named after the artist. His is called From Chicago to
Gethsemane.
What is that?
Isn't that like a biblical town?
Oh, yeah.
Gethsemane?
Yeah, like Brian.
I think it might be.
Like Brian with the 2 foot hair knows anything about the Bible. Yeah. Jared, Gethsemane, he thinks it's something you have to put ointment on. No, I had that, too. Yeah, I had that. I had got it treated in Korea. That's where I caught it. All right, so we're Radio Free in New York. No wonder he bit a fly for $10. You could dare this guy to do anything, and he did. He bit it down on a fly, and it squirted in his mouth, and he won $10.
Yeah, but he wasn't happy about us talking. In fact, he's probably not happy about us talking about it again.
Yeah, but he just wanted everyone to know that he didn't swallow the fly. He just bit it, and it squirted, and he got the $10, but then he spit it out. All right? He's not crazy. You think he's going to swallow it? How about the Water Boys new album, Dream Harder? You got it yet? Well, maybe you will after you hear Preparing to Fly. We are Radio Free New York. New rock. Not just for kids. If you're a new Radio Free New Yorker, like if you just found out about us in the last, let's say, 2 weeks or so, and word is spreading, you give us a call right now at 219-96. Hey, good morning. I'm Kurt, and I'm here with Buff, and we're Radio Free New York. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Good. When did you find out about the show?
About a week and a half ago or so. I just moved in from Rockland County.
You checked it out.
Checked it out.
And how does it sound?
It. Yeah? Great.
Yeah? What do you used to listen to?
I listened to Howard in the morning, actually. And now I listen to, you guys.
That's great. If you do listen to Howard, when he goes to those long, long commercial breaks?
Yep, you can, check in another half hour of your stuff for that.
Right. That's right.
Exactly.
Want to try one more? Okay, hi. Radio Free New York. How you doing?
Good morning. How you doing?
What's the story of your life as far as listening to morning radio goes?
Well, I've heard about it. I saw you guys in the paper. There's been a couple of mentions to it. And I'll be honest with you. I used to be an NEW listener. Too much rap and not enough music. And I want to hear new music.
How old are you?
I'm 39.
39. So you're hip enough for this stuff, right? You remember when, the Led Zeppelins and stuff were new and hip, right?
I remember all of that stuff. I mean, I grew up, in the end of the 60s there. And
let's face it, you haven't changed that much, right?
No, I still want to hear new music.
7:40 at Radio Free New York. Hang on, I want to give you something. In addition to this new one from a band called Osric Tentacles, they have an album called Strangitude. If you got them, smoke them. And if there's anything on your bladders, suck it up. Because here's White Rhino Tea at Radio Free New York. It's a tower hour. now, Fish. School of Fish at Radio Free New York, the Human Cannonball album. Half a Believer is that track, and we've got a couple of copies left to give away in our closet 669. We're in Manhattan. It's a 212 number. Give a call. We'd love to send you a copy of School of Fish's Human Cannonball that contains that track. Give that person a copy of the album. Before that, the Dogs of Lust from the Dusk album, and Hot House Flowers was our compact Disc World hot tip of the morning. David Lang knew it. He said, the more you play one tongue, the better it sounds. And is he right? The album is Songs from the Rain. 44 headed to 70 and sunny today. It's 8:04 at Radio Free New York.
.732 at Radio Free New York. Beneath our air cover, we're on the ground, fighting boring corporate control of morning radio in this town. New York City was once a great radio town, and it will be again someday. We're Radio Free New York. And let's check out U2's album again, Zeropa. This is Some Days Are Better Than Others. Enough said. Chaos Records, that is Deacon Blue, and from the album Whatever You Say, Say Nothing, Your Town. At Radio Free New York, that is some cool music if you ask this DJ. Nice to listen to that stuff on the radio. Come on, somebody else, talking to the other radio stations. Come on, play it. Go ahead, play it.
That one's too good. That one's going to get played.
Yeah, I think so. 7:05 and 76 degrees right now, headed, don't forget, to the upper 90s. By now, I think everybody knows that. That's the weather forecast for, like, the next week. Upper 90s and sticky. I mean, deodorant is a joke right now. Deodorant, you know, with all due respect to the deodorant companies.
Hey, Tross.
Yeah, Kurt.
What happens when you step on the scale?
Oh, God, you don't want to know.
Does it seem like there's, like, somebody else standing there with you and he has suitcases?
Two people.
Froze Fruit, a flagship sponsor of Radio Free New York. Froze Fruit, the coolest way to eat fruit. Got it, Tross?
Got it.
This audience is primed and ready to go. New York City is primed and ready to go. They've known you've been coming up here for a couple of days now. We know the bottom line shows tomorrow night are sold out. Both
yes.
But we got them here this morning, live in concert in support of Radio Free New York. Hey, listen, you Radio Free New Yorkers, if anyone you know is listening to another radio station, you still have a couple of seconds to call them and say, don't miss this one. And also, start your tape machines now. Ladies and gentlemen, live, in concert, live, drive at Radio Free New York, we're so proud to present Bare Naked Ladies! Yeah!
And if there's someone you can live without, then do so. Oh, oh, oh. My new box set. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Wow.
Bare Naked Ladies live in concert here at Radio Free New York. How about it?
I
I know you guys are a little bit too modest to explain this, so I'll do it for you. Just this past Sunday night, these guys won the Juno Award, which is Canada's equivalent to the Grammy for Best Canadian Band of the Year.
Buff, I want to see you in my office right after the show. What are you doing playing music like that? Who do you think you are? It's not what radio's for. Radio's to play safe music and make a lot of money.
Ooh, what a flashback.
Oh, man. That was Material Issue right there. Destination U from Destination Universe and Dramarama. Starting it out, Work for Food from Hi-Fi Sci-Fi. We don't say our names on the radio. We don't say Kurt and Buff a lot. Hi, I'm Kurt. I'm Buff. And it's a Kurt and Buff show. And Kurt and Buff... who cares? It's about the music we're playing, and it's about change on the radio. Drama-rama at Radio Free New York. Incredible is the track off of Hi-Fi Sci-Fi. Blues Traveler in the middle of the set, Believe Me, off of the Save His Soul CD. As we go a little bit deeper into that album, some of the other stations are playing Blues Traveler and Save His Soul, but I haven't heard Believe Me yet anywhere else except Radio Free. Speaking of the other stations, it was a weekend full of firecrackers. Every time I turn on the radio, someone was saying, firecracker this or firecracker that. What the?
It was so funny. The two classic rock stations doing their 4th of July countdown shows, they named them the same, trying to confuse the listeners of either station into thinking that they were listening to the other station. The Firecracker 500 versus the original Firecracker 500.
It's like Ray's Pizza and the original Ray's Pizza. And
right.
The original Ray's Pizza. Was the winner the same on both stations?
Absolutely. Ding, 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 ding.
Oh, on both stations. I want to be like the fifth Beatle of radio. I want to be like everybody else and tell stories that I was there when the plane hit the ground and they stepped onto the tarmac and... oops. That's what it was like at staff meetings at the old station. They'd get in fights over that. We're Radio Free New York. Murray Attaway is going to be here.
I'm the fifth Beatle.
No, I'm the fifth Beatle.
No, I'm the fifth Beatle.
No, I'm the fifth Beatle.
Here at Radio Free New York at 105.9. Thanks for not forgetting the 9. Thanks for tuning us in this morning and making the effort to tune over to 105.9 from wherever you are used to listening to your rock and roll in the mornings. That was the Oyster Band and from the Deserters album, an album that we play all that way for this off of, and the Deserter a little bit deeper for a track called Angels of the River. Did you see this article on page 89 of, in the part 2 section of today's New York Newsday? Page 89 of the part 2 section, it says... quality counts among WNWK fans. And a big picture of Kurt and Buff here. You look really good in this picture, Buff.
You look really good.
I don't look so good, but you do. A nice article by Paul Colford. Thank you very much for paying attention to us, Paul, and writing this. It's about how we started the show, and it points out that for the second straight quarterly survey, we showed up in the ratings, which is quite amazing. You know, we're starting to move up the ladder in some of those, like, important demos, you know, like persons 25-54. That's how they break it up, you know, in Arbitrons. But Arbitron doesn't really work for us on this show.
It's designed for a station that functions 24 hours around the clock with, like, a big positioning statement, like some people say we're classic rock and more. Yeah, they beat that right. Home, you know.
Well, a format
right.
That continues consistently around the clock. Our format that we work here in the mornings starts at 6 a.m., ends at 9, then a different format comes on. So the Arbitron ratings don't really work for us, and I don't think they'll ever accurately reflect what our audience is. I think our audience is a lot bigger than is reflected in these Arbitron ratings. Interestingly, in this last rating book, Howard Stern's ratings came down nearly a full point as that trend continues. So there's something really happening in radio. I just want to read a tiny little piece here in this article. It says, he calls Radio Free New York a little enclave in the morning wars that rage between the big gladiator stations. Well, that's true. But the hunch here, Paul writes, Paul Colford, is that those, 40,000 listeners or so, in putting WNWK-FM on the ratings map for the first time I can recall in the 6 years of this column, are among the most loyal audiences in these parts. These ratings don't really work that well for us, but if you keep telling your friends, who knows what might happen.
11 minutes after 7, new music from Terrence Trent D'Arby. It's called She Kissed Me at 105.9. Don't forget that 9, WNWK Radio Free New York.
At Radio Free New York. We're 105.9 WNWK. We're Radio Free New York. It's for you. It's the home of the free. The Radio Free. At Radio Free New York, and that's Driving Loud, Radio Storm, from Robin Hitchcock and the Egyptians' album Respect. Sting in the middle, She's Too Good for Me, 10 Summoner's Tales, and Big Head Todd, Bittersweet from Sister Sweetly, 46 and sunny highs in the low 70s. The general manager of this radio station has become very uncooperative and doesn't seem to want us to remain on the air anymore. So we might not be on the air anymore after tomorrow. Radio Free New York, if you enjoyed what we've been doing for the last 6 months here, you know the story. You have to go into action now. You got to write some letters. And I wouldn't write them to this station, at least not to management. If you write to this station, you have to write to the owner. His name is Arthur Liu, L-I-U. And the address here is 449 Broadway,
New York, New York, 10013. He's the owner of the station. He is the president of Multicultural Broadcasting Incorporated, Arthur Liu. So make sure you don't write any letters to the general manager here, because he'll bury them and burn them most probably. And write to the media columnists in the city's major papers, the ones who've covered the story of Radio Free New York right from the start. In the Daily News, people like David Hinckley, Jim Farber, Jeff Weingrad. In the Post, Jill Brook and Frank DiGiacomo. Write to New York Newsday. Write to Paul Colford, who's given us a lot of coverage. And New York Magazine, the editor of Fast Tracks. And the Village Voice, Neil Strauss. Those are the people you have to write to. You have to write to other radio stations. Call and write to general managers and program directors of places like NEW, K-Rock, Z100, PLJ, NCN. Anywhere you think, tell them you want Radio Free New York on the air again soon. It's become very tough around here.
Under the best circumstances, it was tough. But now the circumstances have deteriorated. And, to no fault of our own.
We'll talk to some of you on the air today. We'll answer any questions, honestly, about what's going on. And because there's a lot going on. Radio Free New York.
Like the phone is ringing,
so maybe somebody wants to know what's going on.
October 12th.
October 12th, all right.
I guess my question is this a personality issue or is this a money issue?
It's a business issue, I think. But I can't really vouch for the personality of the general manager. It could be partly that, too. This radio station is, it rents airtime, right? And
right.
We rent the airtime from them. So they're not really in the radio business. They're in the equipment rental business. I don't think they have a real understanding of what doing radio is really all about. But it's really a business issue. It's about a lease we signed and a lease that's been broken. I guess they have their motives. I think their motive seems to be to get us off the air for whatever reason. I don't know. Maybe the big corporations have come down with some pressure or something. Good morning. It's Radio Free New York. How you doing?
Hi. Hi. This is Cindy calling.
Hi, Cindy.
Yeah, it's so funny. I can't believe the news about you going off the air.
No, neither can we. It's very sudden, and we'd like to keep doing what we're doing. But it doesn't seem possible under the current circumstances. Lots of problems have come up, and it looks like they're trying to force us off. So,
when you said to contact other stations like NEW or whatever other stations are out there, do you think maybe you'll be picked up by them?
If I was one of the other stations, I would definitely consider it. I would say, hey, this Radio Free New York was a show. It's got an audience. People really dig what they've done on this very small radio station. They put it on the map. Maybe we should pick it up. I think NEW, K-Rock, Z100, PLJ, NCN, and stations like that, if you write to them and express yourself, they'd have to consider it.
Well, good luck to you guys.
Thanks, Cindy.
All right.
Hey, we're here. It's 6:41. We're ready to go into the beloved's album, Conscience, and do what we always do. Go a little bit deeper and give you a better idea what this album's all about. It's out on Atlantic Records. This is the album that gave you Sweet Harmony. We play it a lot. Let's go to You've Got Me Thinking from the beloved at 105.9 WNWK, Radio Free New York. So fine, every day I kick myself from Webb Wilder's Doodad album. And from David Geffen Records, the Water Boys' Dream Harder is coming out pretty soon, their newest album. We already have that track we played for you to start the set, Return of Pan. 46 degrees, sunny today, clear tonight, and sunny tomorrow. It's 7:04 at Radio Free New York. We got a memo a couple of weeks ago saying a failure to comply with any of the above rules and regulations could result in immediate termination. We laughed about it at the time. It was things like chewing gum in the studio or, playing the music a little bit too loud on the air or leaving the door open, stuff like that. You know, but it turns out that they found a coffee cup back on our soundstage after the Peter Himmelman concert, a coffee cup in the bottom of a garbage can, and they came running in with it, not knowing who drank the coffee and made it like a... Did you see the movie...
The Caine Mutiny?
Yeah, about the strawberries. So that's resulting in immediate termination of Radio Free New York, even though... nobody knows who drank the coffee or why, or even why it's cause for termination.
sounds so good in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a perfect morning song. Yet most radio stations would bury a song like that at some other day part, saying, we can't risk playing Deep Forest in morning drive time. Well, I got news for you. Yes, you can. Deep Forest with Sweet Lullaby.
We'll play you some new rock from the Bats, a band out of New Zealand. I think this song may end up in the Heineken Six Pack, which is our six songs recommended that we take into the weekend. Come Friday when we play it back for you. This might be one of my selections.
I love it already. I haven't even heard it yet.
The Bats record for a little record label out of North Carolina called Mammoth Records. Their new CD is Silver Beat. And from it, this is The Valley Floor at Radio Free New York.
Okay, thank you, Buff. Thanks, Buff. I'm Kurt Chaplin. Thank you, Tross. Thank you, DL. You guys ready? Get the side door open. Let's go. Right now. Come on.
New York radio. It's notorious. Some say it's dull. Some say it's laborious. But I know a station down in Chinatown that's here to blow all the conventions down. WNWK is its name. It's gonna make the other stations look lame. Look out, Howard, and your dinosaur rockers. Radio Free, it's a radio shocker. Gonna undo the cork, gonna eat it up with a fork. Man, you're listening to Radio Free New York.
Get down.
Listening to Radio Free New York. WNWK, that's his name.
That's right.
He's gonna make the other stations look mighty lame. So look out, Howard.
Look out, Howard.
You dinosaur rockers.
Rockers.
Radio Free New York, it's a radio shocker.
Shocking.
Gonna undo the cork, gonna eat it up with a fork. Oh. Talking about Radio Free New York. What's up? Yeah.
Break it down.
Down in Chinatown, where you're eating the noodles. They got good loving and tunes, man, by the oodles. You're gonna love it so much, it's gonna shock you to your soul. You're gonna turn that dial, man, and lose control. I'm gonna undo the cork, gonna eat it up with a fork. I'm talking about Radio Free New York.